After 2 weeks of going through Alabama football withdrawals, head coach Nick Saban and the Crimson Tide return to action on Saturday inside Bryant-Denny Stadium as the Crimson Tide take on those Kentucky Wildcats. 3 p.m. Central Time kickoff. Game will be on SEC Network. This is Touchdown Alabama Magazine bringing you another game day preview. I'm yours truly, Stephen M. Smith.
And I'm Patrick Dowd. And Stephen, much like you and I, trying to keep the momentum rolling, Nick Saban trying to keep Alabama's momentum rolling after 2 weeks off.
Now, he talked about this on his Hey Coach Show pad on Thursday, Coach Saban understanding the challenges of when you don't have football for 2 weeks, what are the practices going to be like? What's the energy of the team going to be like? Trying to get guys healthy. But he seemed to be in real good spirits on his show talking about how the guys have taken to things well. They've practiced well. The right focus has been there. The right energy's been there because this is going to be a battle in the trenches this weekend between Alabama and Kentucky.
Yeah, and I think everyone knows it's going to be a really hectic season regardless. I mean, so many teams missing games, rescheduling. It's kind of a mess right now. But I think from what we heard from Nick Saban and the players this past week, they've all handled the off time really well. I know Nick Saban said that on last Saturday, instead of playing LSU, they had a bit of a simulated practice, trying to keep things going, trying to build off the games they've already played. But, you know, like you said, we're going to have to see this week against a Kentucky team that's pretty physical on both sides of the football.
Alabama football fans have been going through 2 weeks worth of withdrawal, so they're happy to see their Crimson Tide take the field this weekend against Kentucky. When you look at Mac Jones, and he's had a big year at the quarterback position, but at one point in time, he was looking to be a part of Big Blue Nation, the football version. In 2017, Kentucky courted him hard in that recruiting process. Mark Stoops really liked Mac Jones. Mac Jones, the respect there, mutual to the Kentucky program. And if he would have chosen the Cats, maybe Kentucky's not in a quarterback situation right now that it's got with Joey Gatewood and Terry Wilson. But Mac Jones chose Alabama, and this week going to be going against a team that he almost chose.
Yeah, I mean, I think he made the right choice, and I think he would be the first one to tell you, because he mentioned in his Monday presser that if he had gone to Kentucky, he probably would have had to play a little earlier than maybe he probably had to face some challenges that he wasn't ready for. I mean, he sat behind at Alabama two fantastic quarterbacks in Jalen Hurts and Tua Tagovailoa. And Nick Saban had mentioned prior that he really sponged up a lot of their knowledge and learned from watching them play. And I think you can see now it's really benefited him. It's a testament to sticking out through a program, learning the offense in and out, and he's having a lot of success now because of it.
Not just that, but also taking that time, Pat, to build up his body. Yes. Throughout the entire offseason, he grew an inch. He's now 6'3". He put on about 9 to 10 healthy pounds on that frame. He's now at 218 pounds, so can take some hits now in a very brutal SEC.
I think there was three players this week that mentioned how skinny he was coming in, even Nick Saban.
Miller Forrestal was one of those players that mentioned how skinny Mac Jones is when he first came in, but now built up at 6'3", 218 pounds, having a great season, and looks to take this game against Kentucky as another opportunity to keep himself in front of the Heisman conversation. But going back to what I mentioned, Pat, about this game being a physical matchup, a stark contrast from what we've seen this season about the offense and scoring at will, the space game, the spread offense. This week, it's going to be a battle in the trenches, and a group that's very excited about that, these Alabama running backs, Najee Harris, Brian Robinson, Jace McClellan, the true freshman from Aledo, Texas. He's going to be looking forward to get some carries in this matchup, but these running backs very excited to get up and down the field on this tough Kentucky front. Talk about the running backs, Pat. This is going to be a fun game for them.
It's going to be a fun game for them, definitely. I mean, Najee Harris, he's probably salivating after having 2 weeks off, looking to get some sort of physicality going. Same with Brian Robinson. And I think everyone's excited to see what Jace McClellan is going to bring to the table. I'm sure he's another guy who's not too happy about how he got his opportunity, especially with Trey Sanders going down in the car wreck. Everyone's hoping that he's going to be okay, but no, it just goes to show you got to be the next man up, got to step up. I know Justin Smith, our scouting recruiting analyst, is really high on Jace. He wrote out an article, I think, last week about how it was detailing all of his talents and whatnot. And Nick Saban's mentioned he'd always looking for the running back to change the pace back, you know, provide a little bit of a home run hitter. But Jace can do that, but he's also pretty physical in and of himself.
Also, along with that, Pat, watch for McClellan out the backfield as a wide receiver as well. He's got a really unique gear to him, and a guy that after Alabama lost Keenan Robinson to an opt-out before the season started, you have a guy that can provide that speed, that can provide some power and some weaponry coming out of the backfield in the passing game as well. So these running backs very, really much looking forward to running behind this offensive line this week against Kentucky. But as we get into now this Alabama-Kentucky matchup, Kentucky offensively, Pat, they've got a strong offensive line. They got a great running game. They got two really good backs, but the passing game lacking there under head coach Mark Stoops.
It's definitely lacking there, but I would more attribute their success to they know who they are. They're a big physical team. I mean, they're dead last in passing offense in the SEC, but they're second in rushing. They know exactly who they are. And the way they want to hurt you is with Terry Wilson and the read option, along with Chris Rogers, the running backs, and the Sim Rose Jr. I mean, all three of those guys have combined for over 1,200 yards, I believe, on the season. And, you know, Alabama has struggled with some read options in the past. I mean, with their linebackers crowding the line, and they're going to have success with on the ground, and they're going to have, but I mean, they're going to also have to have success with the air, because you can't, they're going to try to shorten the game as much as they can. But you have to be able to throw the ball and have to have a more widespread offense in order to score points against Alabama and keep up with them.
Now, Coach Saban did talk about on Thursday, Pat, on how Kentucky will look to take some shots. They'll try to take some shots downfield, but they want to run the football, whether it's between the tackles or some jet motion to the outside. They want to find a way to get to the edge and get their big physical offensive line on these Alabama linebackers. Kentucky, much like Alabama, on its offensive line, returns four starters from last year. Now, defensively, under Mark Stoops, this is a Kentucky team that's changed the culture of what it once was. When Stoops first came in 2013, there was some growing pains there. But ever since the 2016 season, this program has been on a roll, winning football games, including, you know, a 10-win season in 2018. Just thinking about how weird this 2020 season is, Kentucky is second in the SEC in scoring defense. Crazy. Second in the SEC is Kentucky, allowing just 21.3 points per game. Kentucky fourth in the SEC in total defense. They're first in the SEC in pass yards allowed, giving up just 214 pass yards per game. They're also second in the SEC in pass efficiency rating, with a rating of 125.03 giving up. So you can already tell how crazy this year is with Kentucky leading the pack in a lot of these categories, or among the top groups in the pack in these categories. And the Wildcats, led by Jamin Davis, the junior at linebacker, 73 tackles on the year for him. They've got some pass rushers. J.J. Weaver, 5.5 tackles for loss for him. Two quarterback hurries. Jamar Watson, that being the pass rusher. Watson, 3.5 sacks, 4 tackles for loss, and 5 quarterback pressures for him on the season. Kelvin Joseph, the transfer they got from LSU, in the defensive backfield, Joseph leads the team with 3 interceptions. So Kentucky, they've got some guys defensively that will look to challenge Alabama on all 3 levels of the game, on the defensive line, linebacker, and then the secondary. But this Kentucky defensive front, they've heard so much about this Alabama offensive line. They want to challenge the likes of Landon Dickerson, of Deontay Brown, Emil Ekior, Alex Netherwood, and Evan Neal. So this is going to be old-fashioned smash mouth in the trenches. Which group up front can flex some muscle? Gap discipline important. Reading the keys important. Following the football important. But also, who just wants it more? Who has that dog mentality more? Play by play, you're going to get a fresh breath of old school football between Kentucky and Alabama. And Nick Saban kind of happy to see that.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's also a testament to the job Mark Stoops has done over the years. I mean, it wasn't too long ago where some fans would look at this game and think of it as an extra bye week. But I mean, Kentucky shows up to play every week, and they're a big physical team. You can't overlook them. And I think that's just a testament to the coaching and sticking with it, just recruiting well, developing well. And I mean, now it turns into a competitive game every year.
Kentucky 3-4 on the season. Could very easily be 5-2, maybe even 6-1. They were in the game against Georgia, only lost by 11. They only lost by 10 to Mizzou. They had Ole Miss. They down the wire. Only lost by 1, 42-41. So Kentucky has been in a lot of these football games. So a stiffer defensive matchup for Alabama. Going to be fun to watch here, Pat. But the line on this game, I believe 31. Does Alabama cover this? I mean, Coach Saban doesn't have anything against Mark Stoops. Is this line covered?
I mean, I think so. I mean, contrary to the colors of my shirt that I'm wearing, I'm not rooting or pulling for Kentucky.
I was wondering why you chose that shirt.
I mean, I am the most unbiased journalist in the SEC, so I'm going with Alabama in this game. I think they will cover despite the 2 weeks off. I just don't think – I mean, Kentucky may shorten the game a little bit on them, but I just don't think their passing attacks will be nearly enough to score as much points as they need to.
As much as I want to see Bama cover, I think I would pull the under. If I'm a betting man this week, I would pull the under just due to both teams are going to want to establish the line of scrimmage most importantly. But then number two, I mean – this is a game where Coach Saban is going to call off the dogs at some point. Nothing against Mark Stoops. He wants to be able to have those first stringers go out there, lay down the law, but then get some reps for Bryce Young, get some reps for some of these younger guys. So I can see this game teetering slightly underneath the 31-point spread, but if it does hit the 31 or over, I would not be surprised. But folks, Alabama taking on Kentucky on Saturday, 3 p.m. Central Time kickoff, Bryant-Denny Stadium. SEC Network will have the call after two bye weeks, the Crimson Tide, and Coach Saban getting back on the field with a 6-0 record, trying to continue its push toward the SEC Championship and contend for a national title. But for all of us here at Touchdown Alabama Magazine, I'm Stephen M. Smith.
And I'm Patrick Dowd.
And baby, we'll see you guys next week.